Blessed Mary, Christ have mercy. Lord Jesus, your word made flesh in the splendor of the Father, Lord have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, strength of those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas, and since without you mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your commands, we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever.
Reading from the first book of Kings. After the death of Naboth, the Lord said to Elisha the Tishbite, "Start down to meet Ahab, king of Israel, who rules in Samaria. He will be in the vineyard of Naboth, of which he has come to take possession. This is what you shall tell him. The Lord says, after murmuring, do you also take possession? For this, the Lord says, in the place where the dogs licked up the blood of Naboth, the dogs shall lick up your blood too." Ahab said to Elisha, "Have you found me out, my enemy?" "Yes," he answered, "because you have given yourself up to doing evil in the Lord's sight, I am bringing evil upon you. I will destroy you and will cut off every male in Ahab's line, whether slave or freeman in Israel. I will make your house like that of Jeroboam, son of Nebat, and like that of Baasha, son of Ahijah, because of how you have provoked me by leading Israel into sin. Against Jezebel too," the Lord declared, "the dogs shall devour Jezebel in the district of Jezreel. When one of Ahab dies in the city, dogs will devour him. When one of them dies in the field, the birds of the sky will devour him. Indeed, no one gave himself up to the doing of evil in the sight of the Lord, as did Ahab, urged on by his wife Jezebel. He became completely abominable by following idols, just as the Amorites had done, whom the Lord drove out before the children of Israel." When Ahab heard these words, he tore his garments and put on sackcloth over his bare flesh. He fasted, slept in the sackcloth, and went about subdued. Then the Lord said to Elisha the Tishbite, "Have you seen that Ahab has humbled himself before me? Since he has humbled himself before me, I will not bring the evil in his time. I will bring the evil upon his house during the reign of his son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
Have mercy on me, O God, in your goodness. In the greatness of your compassion, wipe out my offense. Thoroughly wash me from my guilt, and of my sin cleanse me. Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned. For I acknowledge my offense, and my sin is always before me. Against you only have I sinned, and done what is evil in your sight. Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned. Turn away your face from my sins, and blot out all my guilt. Free me from blood guilt, O God, my saving God, that my tongue shall revel in your justice. Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "You have heard that it was said, 'You shall love your neighbor and hate your enemy.' But I say to you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you, that you may be children of your heavenly Father. For he makes his sun rise on the bad and the good, and causes rain to fall on the just and the unjust. For if you love those who love you, what recompense will you have? Do not the tax collectors do the same? And if you greet your brothers only, what is unusual about that? Do not the pagans do the same? So be perfect, just as your heavenly Father is perfect." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
Are you perfect? Is it not? I don't know. Is there anybody here who qualifies under the Mary Poppins clause of practically perfect in every way? No? Maybe? Is anybody awake? There we go. Okay. We have laughter. We have movement. Because, again, when we look at that line, "Be perfect as your heavenly Father is perfect," that is such a high bar to clear. And we look at that and go, it's impossible. But you're also talking about the same person, Jesus Christ, who said, talks about a camel passing through the eye of a needle, like it's easier than a rich man entering heaven. And the line he says to the apostles when they look and go, "Lord, you're crazy." What is the next line that comes out of our Lord's mouth? "It is not impossible for God. All things are possible for God." We have to realize very quickly that we cannot be prideful in thinking we can accomplish this all on our own. None of us can do that. The Christian life is not something that can be done on one's own. It has to be received in everything we do from God. Period, end of story, end of sentence, end of paragraph. You cannot do this life of Christianity without humble submission to our Lord in all things. Because to even consider being perfect as our Heavenly Father is perfect, you look at the lives of the saints, what's the first thing they recognize? Their sinfulness. Their need for mercy. Their need to constantly repent. Their need to turn their lives more and more fully to Jesus Christ because they recognize just how much they can't do it. But we venerate them. Why do we venerate them? Because they lived a life of God that constantly started with humility and turning themselves over to Him. And for every fall they made, they brought it to His mercy and they began again. That is how we will be perfect as our Heavenly Father is perfect. All the readings we just heard have some aspect of that mercy of God. To understand that we're going to love our enemies, we have to again understand that we are fallen too. That, as we heard in the response to our song, we need to be merciful to us, O God, who have sinned. We need to seek the mercy. Even Ahab, who has that stinging judgment passed against him by Elijah, who's renouncing God like all these things because he's fully turned his back on the Lord, he repents. We heard it right at the end of the story. You and I, my dear friends, as we make our way forward, we need to constantly be examining our own hearts and seeing where those areas are where we're not turning ourselves over to God. So as we go throughout the rest of this day, let us lift up our hearts to the Lord. Let us make sure we examine our own interiority and say to our Lord, "Lord, help me to be perfect as you are perfect, not through my own We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear
our prayer. That our prayers to those who persecute us will help free us from persecution. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear
that the dead may enjoy forever the unfailing compassion of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear
our prayer. Let us remember the people of St. Patrick's in the prayer of this liturgy. Let us also offer our own prayers to the Lord in the silence of our own hearts. We pray to the Lord. Good and gracious God, help us to be humble and to receive the gift of your love, mercy, and grace, to lead us and to guide us on every step that you lay before us, and to help be your witnesses in the midst of the world. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, and we have bread and life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
And the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all our sins.
O God, the offerings presented here provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament. Grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere we give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God. For all you have in need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving itself your gift, since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so, in the company of the choirs and angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna. similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life, chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis our Pope and Robert our Bishop, all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people, as we walk our ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, in our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with Saint Patrick, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Holy Father, keep in your name those who have given thee, that they may be one as we are one, says the Lord. I now invite you to join me in a prayer of spiritual communion for all those who are joining us electronically this morning. We pray, my Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Saint Michael, the Archangel.